I am very convinced this is going to be the most entertaining preseason ever. Coming off a year where we didn't even have a preseason, I didn't really miss it that much, to be completely honest. I think the preseason, for the most part, is done. I tend not to pay that close attention to it because the starters play 1 to 2 series to shake off the rust. Nobody does anything special. It's all vanilla offense versus vanilla defense. But all of the quarterback battles around the league this preseason stand out like no other. A true quarterback battle doesn't happen that often. Usually 99% of their teams know who their starting quarterback is, and as one improves or the starter begins to really struggle, the coach will make the switch during the regular season. But it's more rare for a quarterback to share first team reps before the season starts with what little time they have. And going into the first preseason game, we have all our eyes on Jameis Winston versus Taysom Hill, Drew Locke versus Teddy Bridgewater, Justin Fields versus Andy Dalton, Jimmy G versus Trey Lance, and even Mac Jones versus Cam Newton. On top of that, we'll get to see Trevor Lawrence and Zach Wilson take NFL starting snaps for the first time. But today, I want to focus on the quarterback battles, explain why they're even in this spot, and what I think each team should do. The first team I mentioned is the Saints and their situation with Jameis and Taysom Hill. And the Saints are a dark horse contender this year. It's weird that 3 dark horse contenders are on this list that aren't even sure of what their most important position is in the Saints, Patriots, and Niners. I'm going to spend the least amount of time on this one because I already did a full video on why I think Jameis is going to have a breakout season. He should definitely start because he's a better player overall, and Taysom's spot on that team is also incredibly important to their success, and they're a better team overall when he's in that utility role. I also had a video yesterday about Michael Thomas, so if you're a Saints fan and you're really looking forward for me talking about this, then I recommend checking those videos out. Let's start with the Niners because this one for me came out of nowhere. I felt like there was absolutely no chance that Trey Lance was going to start week one or any point during the front half of the season, not due to injury, and it was looking like I was right through rookie camp and OTAs, but they had 40 days off before training camp, and apparently Trey Lance went into Captain America's cryo chamber and came out the Winter Soldier. Because when someone asked Benjamin Albright what he heard from Lance, people were saying that he was Mahomes 2.0. Now this did scare Jimmy G, because I was also hearing more things from Kyle Shanahan. It sounds like he's killing it with the deep ball and deep crossing routes over the middle of the field. Not only were these concerns with him coming out of college, but these are also staples in the 49ers offense. Combine this with his running ability, improvise, and how dynamic their run game can be if they could implement read options, jet sweep options, and quarterback counters, Jimmy was winning this battle based off of consistency and familiarity with the offense. In the 49ers camp, it sounds like Jimmy is the one struggling in the team throwing drills, where Trey will complete 14 throws in a row and then make a Mahomes-like throw. Kai will not be one to slow play this. He's going to put out the person that gives them the best chance to win, especially in the NFC West when every game counts. Kyle Shanahan has already said that Trey Lance is going to have his own certain sets, but look for him to get a lot of reps during the preseason, and we're going to see how things develop. My initial thought was Lance was going to take the entire season behind Jimmy G. The Niners were going to be very good, and Trey didn't get many snaps in college, and it might take a lot of adjusting and growing to be ready to take over a playoff or Super Bowl caliber team, but on this one, I'm going to trust Kyle Shanahan. I know he'll throw Lance in during certain sets, make him the full-time starter when he thinks he's the best option to win games, and based on what it sounds like Lance has been doing in camp, I would guess sooner than later. I know it's gonna gnaw at Kyle during games. What if Trey could have ran for that first down? Or the playbook could be so much wider if I had a dual threat guy. And the Bears situation is almost identical to the Niners. A quarterback who was said to be 100% the starter no matter what, but after a very impressive training camp for Justin Fields, it's become of a, well, we'll wait and see what happens. I think Fields should start week one. The only reason I think they might have to wait till week two is avoiding having his first start ever be against the Rams defense and a Stafford looking to prove himself. That would be one of the hardest opening weeks ever, and I only see upside to starting Fields, especially on a Bears team that is very excited for a potentially elite quarterback, and knowing they're not contenders for a ring this year, but they have a lot of pieces they can grow around Fields. I think Matt Nagy is just waiting for the preseason just like we all are, because if Fields comes out and absolutely balls out, then I don't think it'll take all but 2 seconds for all of Bear Down Nation to be all over the internet screaming to start him, but just another reason I can't wait for preseason to get here. Drew Lock and Teddy Bridgewater might be the most interesting one to me because it isn't a rookie in the mix. We have Drew Lock, who will be going into his third season, and up to this point, he's given me Andrew Wiggins of the NFL vibes. I feel like we all see the raw talent that is Drew Lock. We see his arm, we see the creativity and the explosive plays, but we also see the timidness, almost like he's confused on what's going on, a lot of boneheaded plays that resulted in 15 interceptions in just 13 games. On the other hand, we have Teddy Bridgewater, who was brought in to either push Drew Lock and motivate him or be the consistent veteran to take over when Drew Lock struggles. I think Teddy would leave this team to more wins this season, but where the Broncos are at right now, they have a very good defense. They have an offense that has Cortland Sutton, Jerry Jeudy, KJ Hamler, Noah Fant, Javonte Williams, and Melvin Gordon in the backfield. So this team is loaded and definitely on the market for a big name quarterback like Aaron Rodgers next year, maybe Deshaun Watson if he ends up being innocent. And in a division where they might be the worst team or close to it, I think they should let Drew Lock be the starter and have to lose it, because this team could be special with the right quarterback. So put your money this season on a guy who we know has an incredibly high ceiling. I would prefer this just because we already know Teddy Bridgewater's ceiling. But we are talking about the preseason, because last year Teddy on the Panthers had a squad without McCaffrey, and the year before that we saw him go 5-0 taking over the Saints team after Drew Brees got hurt. So if Teddy comes out with a stacked receiving core and can go out and be dynamic and win games, then my opinion might change. But that is why there's so much weight on this preseason with all of the quarterback battles. And finally, Mac Jones and Cam Newton. This one is so interesting to me because I couldn't think of two more opposite quarterbacks. I mean, just look at them side by side. To me, this is also Cam's to lose. From everything I've heard at Patriot Camp, it sounds like Mac Jones is performing very well and is way ahead of where they thought he was going to be. But I also heard Cam is having a great camp as well. Based off of last year and how weird it was with COVID, the opt-outs, Cam getting COVID, I think I saw a lot more from him last year than other people did. But after a huge offseason, Cam is healthy and they're in a division where if they aren't careful, they could fall to third and out of the playoffs. So to me, that's why they go with the former MVP, the one with playoff and Super Bowl experience, and it'll be a great fit with their run game behind that awesome offensive line. I know that they love that they could scramble for first downs with Cam. The 3rd and 2, the 4th and 2 were pretty much guarantees when they let him run in heavy sets. That is Patriot football, and I don't see them getting away from that lightly. So to me, no matter how good Mac Jones throws the ball this year, I think Cam's running ability and experience will keep him in the game, because Bill is not ready for another reset year. He saw Brady go out and win a ring, and now he wants his. Unless Cam absolutely shits the bed and has a horrible throwing exhibition and turns the ball over like crazy, but then all the new weapons this year in the system and a steady run game, I just don't see Mac Jones playing this year. But that being said, I'm still super excited to see Mac Jones playing in the preseason, because I think he's going to be the long-term solution for this Patriots team. I think Cam will find a new team next year and they will try and recreate Brady with Mac Jones. So in that aspect, I'm excited to see him play. But to me, this is less of a quarterback battle and more of a regular Cam is the starter unless he sucks. But let me know what you guys think. Let me know which competition you were most confused about. For me, it's probably Jimmy G and Trey Lance, just because I was right up until this point of when training camp came out. I wasn't too high on Trey Lance. I said he could be the best quarterback in this entire draft based off of everything, but I think he needs a full year, maybe a year and a half, before he's ready to go out there. But apparently he has put in an insane amount of work in those 40 days off and has come out and absolutely balling. That's the one I'm gonna have my eyes on the most, but let me know what you guys think. Make sure to like this video if you like videos like these. Make sure to comment down below what you think, and make sure to subscribe if you enjoy daily sports content. I appreciate you guys so much. Thank you for checking out the channel, and as always, I will see you tomorrow. Peace.